Hi students, this is Ramalakshmi, physics faculty. Today our topic is motion under gravity. So first of all, what is acceleration due to gravity? We know acceleration, rate of change of velocity is called acceleration. When a body is projected in upward direction or in free fall, here acceleration is exerted on the object because of the gravitational force of attraction. So, what is acceleration due to gravity? The uniform acceleration of a freely falling body towards the center of the earth due to earth's gravitational force of attraction is called acceleration due to gravity. The direction of acceleration due to gravity is towards the center of the earth. So, acceleration due to gravity, it is denoted with the letter G. The value of G is not constant. It varies from place to place, planet to planet. So, G value is not constant. But at the given place, G value is constant. So, on the surface of the earth, G value is maximum at poles, minimum at the equator, and G is equals to zero at the center of the earth. So, G is maximum at poles and G is minimum at equator. And the G value is equals to zero at the center of the earth. But at the given place, G value is constant. So, the value of G doesn't depend upon shape, size and mass of the objects. Whatever the shape of the object and the size of the object, acceleration due to gravity value is a constant. So, generally, we can get the value of G 9.8 meter per second square or 10 meter per second square. So, remember these two values. In problems, maximum we can take these two values only. So, G value is 9.8 meter per second square and R 10 meter per second square. Equations of motion. V is equals to u plus at, s is equals to ut plus half at square, v square minus u square is equals to 2as. So, when we can use equations of motion, when an object is moving with constant acceleration, then only we can use the equations of motion. So, when a body is in free fall or projected in upward direction, then, acceleration due to gravity is a constant. So, we can use the equations of motion in case of the gravity also. So, motion under gravity, how can these equations of motion changes? So, once check the first equation of motion, V is equals to u plus at, where u is initial velocity, v is the final velocity, and A is the constant acceleration. So, S is the displacement. So, to find out the total displacement of the object, we can use the equation S is equals to ut plus half at square. So, in this equation, we don't know the final velocity. We know time and initial velocity at the same time, acceleration. Then, we use the second equation of motion. So, in given problem, we don't know about the time. We know the final velocity, initial velocity. Then to calculate the displacement, use the third equation of motion. V square minus u square is equals to 2as. So, other than these three equations, we have another equation also. We called that equation is Snth equation. Snth is equals to u plus a into n minus half. To calculate the total distance traveled by the object, we can use this equation. But at any particular instant of time, we want the distance traveled by the object. Then instead of a second equation of motion, we can use this equation, yes, nth equation, where n is that particular time distance traveled by the object at third second. So in place of n, take 3. So nth equation gives the distance traveled by the object at any particular instant of time. When a body is projected in upward direction, what about the sign of acceleration due to gravity? Is it positive or negative? When a body is in free fall, what about the direction of g? Is it positive or negative? Okay, let us discuss. In physics, plus and minus only represents the direction. This is one-dimensional motion. So when a body is projected in upward direction or free fall, so we need a vertical axis. Okay, let it be y axis. In upward direction, positive y axis. In downward direction, negative y axis. Remember one thing. Here when you take in upward direction negative y axis, not at all a problem. But conventionally we follow some rules because to maintain same at everywhere. That's it. In upward direction when we take positive means, so in downward direction it becomes to negative. Maybe in upward direction negative means downward direction becomes to positive. When a body is projected in upward direction, initial velocity or final velocity, velocity is positive because in upward direction y is positive. So velocity also positive. In which direction velocity is acting? Upward direction. So velocity is positive in upward direction. And here acceleration due to gravity. What about acceleration? Acceleration due to gravity is always acting in downward direction towards the center of the earth. Either body is upward projected or free fall, whatever, g is acting only in downward direction. That means object is projected in upward direction, g is only negative. G is negative. And what about the distance traveled by the body? Vertically upward. So S is replaced with the H. So H is positive, along positive y direction. H is positive. So try to understand the sign conventions. Here y is positive in upward direction. So velocity is positive, height is positive, but acceleration due to gravity is negative. Okay, when your body is free fall, then in downward direction, negative y axis. Then what about the velocity? Velocity is negative and h is also negative and g, there is no change. G is negative. So in upward g negative only, in downward also g is negative only. Okay, let us check the equations to get the clarity. In upward direction, when a body is projected in upward direction, first equation, v is equals to u plus at. So final, here we will discuss later when initial velocity becomes to 0 and the final velocity is 0. First only check the equations. So first of all, in upward direction, first equation, v positive, u also positive, but a only negative. So minus jt. And second equation, in place of s, height h and ut minus half jt square. And third equation, v square, v is positive only, u also positive only, remains the same. V square minus u square is equals to minus 2ah, because here x acceleration in place of a, take minus g, and it becomes minus 2g h. And fourth equation, snth equation. So snth is equals to u in place of a minus g into n minus half. When a body is moving in downward direction, then equations of motion. First equation. So velocity is negative, acceleration due to gravity also negative, height also negative. Then first equation, minus v is equals to minus u minus gt. So take minus common and cancel on both sides. V is equals to u plus gt. And check the second equation. Yes, minus h in place of u minus ut, and in place of a minus half gt square. So in all these equations we are not changed time, because we know time is a scalar quantity, so it doesn't depends upon the directions. So you don't change in place of t, t remains same. So minus h is equals to minus ut minus half gt square. Here also take minus common and cancel on both sides, then h is equals to ut plus half gt square. So second equation. And third equation, in place of v, minus v whole square, minus in formula only minus is there, and in place of u, minus u whole square is equals to 2 into in place of a minus g, and in place of s minus h. So minus v whole square becomes to v square, minus minus u whole square u square, so minus of minus plus 2g h. And check the last equation also. So last equation, snth equation. So minus sn is equals to minus u minus g of n minus half. So snth is equals to u plus g of n minus half. So once observe all the equations, so the only change in upward direction, just in place of acceleration put minus g, then we get all the equations, and in place of acceleration plus g in downward direction. But you don't think in that way, so perfectly learn the sign conventions. In one dimension that is not at all a problem, but in two dimensional motion when we are doing problems, it is very very important to understand in which direction we have to take plus sign and a minus sign. So when we take the positive y axis in upward direction, all the physical quantities becomes to positive. And in downward direction also, when we take negative means all the physical quantities becomes to negative except acceleration due to gravity. So acceleration due to gravity only acting in downward direction, either upward or downward, but g is acting in downward direction only. I hope you get the clarity regarding sign convention. Still, do you have any doubts regarding the topic or any other topics? Comment to me. Definitely, I will give the reply. Okay, now coming to the next topic. Equations of motion. When a body is projected vertically downwards, what is the difference between free fall and projection? So, just when we drop this body, we are not providing any initial velocity, just dropping. So, initial velocity is zero. This is called free fall. But when a body is forcefully throw this object, that means we are providing certain velocity, initial velocity to the object, then we called projected. Okay, this is a projected vertically downward direction. Initial velocity is not equals to zero. But in case of the free fall, initial velocity is zero. Okay, now equations of motion when a body is projected vertically downward direction. Now, first equation becomes to v is equals to u plus gt, because both sides minus, minus cancelled on both sides, so then we get the equation b is equals to u plus gt. And second equation also, h is equals to ut plus half gt square. And b square minus u square is equals to 2gh. And the sth equation is equals to u plus g into n minus half. And let us check in case of a free fall also. In free fall, initial velocity is equals to 0. So first equation, in place of u put 0, then v is equals to gt. And the second equation, in first ut place it becomes to 0, then h is equals to half gt square. And v square is equals to 2gh. And the sth equation becomes to g of n minus half. Okay, here from this equation, h is equals to half gt square. T is equals to square root of 2h by g. Time taken by the object to cover h height. T is equals to square root of 2h by g. And from this, the final velocity of the object v is equals to square root of 2gh. So once check here, to calculate the time, t is equals to square root of 2h by g and v is equals to square root of 2gh. So these equations are in case of a free fall, and these equations are in case of the projected, vertically projected in downward direction. Okay, next equations of motion, when a body is projected in upward direction. So without providing the initial velocity, object not moving in upward direction. So initial velocity is compulsory. But after reaching certain height, because of acceleration due to gravity, acceleration is acting in downward direction, but object is moving in upward direction, then it becomes to the negative acceleration. It provides the retardation. So after reaching certain height, velocity of the object becomes to zero, but acceleration is not equals to zero. So after reaching certain height, we call that height is maximum height. So at maximum height, final velocity is zero, but acceleration is not equals to zero. So in all these equations, our assumption is we are not to consider the air resistance. Otherwise, the air resistance changes the motion of the body, because we know air resistance is nothing but frictional force. So frictional force opposes the motion of the body, then we get the different times. So here only our assumption is we are not considered the air resistance. So without air resistance, so the final velocity of the object is, so the final velocity of the object is zero, but acceleration is not equals to zero. So first equation, final velocity is zero. So then in place of v, zero is equals to u minus gt. And from this, u is equals to gt. And from this, t is equals to u by g. And next, the second equation, h is equals to ut minus half gt square. And third equation, v square becomes to 0. So minus u square is equals to minus 2gh. So on both sides, minus get cancelled. From this, h is equals to, we called this height is maximum height. So h maximum is equals to u square by 2g. Second equation is equals to u minus g into n minus half. Now check the equations carefully. Here, u square is equals to 2gh. So, the initial velocity of upward projecting body, u is equals to, from this, u is equals to square root of 2gh. So, here there is no air resistance. The initial velocity of a upward projecting body is u and h is the maximum height. Then u is equals to square root of 2gh. Then the same body is returns in downward direction. The final velocity of a freely falling body is v is equals to square root of 2gh. So from these two, what we understand here? The initial velocity of a upward projecting body is equals to final velocity of a freely falling body when air resistance is absent. So u is equals to v. So when u is equals to v means, here we get t is equals to u by z. And here from this, v is equals to zt. And from this, t is equals to v by z. But what we know? U is equals to v. So we take the equation t is equals to u by z. Time of ascent, time of descent. The time taken by a upward projecting body to reach maximum height is called time of ascent. Time of descent, the time taken by a freely falling body to reach the ground is called time of descent. So time of ascent is equals to u by g. And the time of descent also equals to u by z when air resistance is absent. Next, time of flight. The total time taken by a body. Total time taken by a body. How much time that body is in air is called time of flight. Capital T, time of flight is equals to time of ascent plus time of descent. Time of ascent u by z plus time of descent u by z, that is equals to 2 u by z. So remember this formula: time of ascent u by z, time of descent also u by z, and the time of flight is equals to 2 u by z. So maximum height formula, h maximum is equals to u square by 2g. So we know at the given place, acceleration due to gravity is constant. When g is constant, the maximum height reached by the body is directly proportional to square of the initial velocity. Maybe when u is constant and g varies, then maximum height is inversely proportional to the acceleration due to gravity. So remember this. And next, one more point here. The initial velocity of a upward projecting body is equals to final velocity of a freely falling body. Then u is equals to v is equals to square root of 2gh. Different applications of freely falling body and upward projecting body we will discuss in another video. So, kids, students, thank you everyone.